Welcome in Salzburg at the Karajan Music Tech Conference. Let's meet inspiring people and discover new technologies. Let's go!
There are many tech conferences, there are many music conferences, but as far as I know, there's only one classical music technology conference, and that is Karajan Music Tech. So welcome, everyone.
Let's ask some speakers about their personal passion and how they see the future of classical music.
My creative passion is making music, making art, and bringing creativity to more people.
I grew up with classical music, and now that I'm a grown-up, I work in the music business, so it's passion and my profession coming together.
I'd like to bring music to as many people as possible, and today, if you don't do that with technology, then you know it's not gonna work. So my passion is to understand music better through technology.
It took me a long time to really be able to define my personal passion. My personal passion is storytelling.
My passion is certainly music. Music as one of the oldest things that creates emotions.
You know what? It's not music. I love to hear stuff. Because once you realize you're actually not into music but into sort of listening or hearing, then all of a sudden everything becomes music. Wow. So look, like I am now not standing here and being in a whatever and having noises around me. I'm in a symphony. That's where I am.
He knows, you don't have to tell
you
her.
You already know, it's so long.
Behind me is the innovation lab of the Karajan Music Tech Conference. Let's discover the new startups and what kind of new technologies they have to show us.
It's a computer that is fed with 800 compositions of Mozart's. Whatever you send to it, like a few notes, it will respond in the style of Mozart's.
Gramophy is a music streaming service focusing on one particular genre, classical. We're bridging the worlds of on-demand streaming and radio.
We help you to become the guitar player you've always wanted to be.
We are creating personalized practice routines with our app. Our app also listens to you play.
We create software that our users use to create digital scores. So Nicholas takes digital scores created in MuseScore and turns them into artwork like this. So this is Autumn from the Four Seasons, and you read the visualization like a clock face, starting from the 12 o'clock position all the way around. That tells you where you are in the piece. Each of these circles represents a note in the score, and the size of the circle indicates the duration, the length of the note, and the distance from the center is the pitch.
Vincent Favra, the CEO of MuseMap, a cognitive technologies company that revolutionizes music recommendation based on a humanized algorithm. We do it with a neural music network that is encompassing 3 billion data points.
We are showing two things. The one thing is the 3D upmix and the virtualization of the Herbert von Karajan recording of 5th Beethoven, but also, of course, using our famous HE1 headphone, which is, well, the expensive headphone of the world, and we also think it's the best headphone.
We have a stage. We're called LinkedIn of Classical Music. 30,000 members coming from the musicians, ensembles, promoters, managers, all coming together on a huge platform.
Our idea is to have a mobile recording studio, actually a shipping container. Can we put this in the front of maybe Juilliard and make a global audition of, let's say, you know, who are the hottest talent, what is up and coming?
People want to get to know the artists, whether they're pop artists, whether they're jazz artists, or whether they're classical artists. They want more intimate contact with them, and classical music really needs to address this and offer those kind of possibilities. Virtual reality offers possibilities with classical music that you can't experience in real life. So that, for example, you can put on your glasses, you can walk through the orchestra while they're performing.
Yes. I saw the amazing apps like that bring back to me through an app all the background information. They teach me about how to listen to music.
This is like an epitome of a lot of creative minds that come together here.
So technology should be there to democratize experiences and to democratize music.
We make sure that it really belongs to people.
A new way of classical music is celebrated more like a rock concert.
To be honest, I've been to classical music concerts where people just go crazy because they love it so much. Think about Karajan.
He was pushing technology. He made the Japanese make the 72 minutes because of his Ninth Symphony, and that's what I need. Yeah. And then, okay, and then he, in return, he got a, you know, physical plant here in Europe. The first plant of CDs was in Salzburg.
Take these amazing experiences that we have here at the festival in Salzburg, all over the world, in great concert performances, and bring it to the people where they are, at home, and on their mobile phones, in their VR goggles, you know, to really expand the power of music to more and more people.
The future of classical music in three words?
Yes.
Whoa. technology-driven creativity.
Wow.
Interesting, exciting, unexpected.
Youthfulness.
Yes.
And accessibility.
Vibrant, powerful, and fully immersive.
That we acknowledge the health value that.
Social, digital, authentical.
Access for everyone, anywhere, to the experiences that they would like to have, and affordable for everyone.
Which words? Curiosity?
Yeah.
What else? What are you?
Curiosity, passion, and heritage.
Wonderful.
How about curiosity? You like that?
I love it.
My dream vision of classical music is that the people who are in the classical music business start seeing it as something that should be more open, more inclusive, more experimental. But yeah, be more open-minded.
Wonderful.
With these inspiring words and this wonderful drop of Austrian wine, we're going to say goodbye from the Karajan Music Tech Conference and looking forward to see you maybe next year. Cheers.
Cheers!